Vacationing and recreation in the great outdoors of Ogemaw County is described as taking you back to your childhood and all the fun you had as you enjoyed being outdoors. Today we're taking you to a great nature playground for hikes, bikes, golf, and amusements. From today's show, we encourage you to choose the places and activities to spend a day, a long weekend, or an entire vacation. Leave the payment and the sounds of the suburbs. Trade them in for a wide variety of hills, lakes, and streams of Ogemaw County. I'm ready to head for the hills. Remember summer camp? Not far from the urban areas is Camp Timbers, where camp activities abound.
Timbers to talk here with Brian today because there's so many activities for families, individual things to do here in Camp Timbers, and we're excited to be here. So wanted to showcase it and show it off.
Well, good. Now this is a YMCA camp.
This is. Yes.
Okay, so what does it mean? Who can come here?
Open to anybody. So YMCA camp, it means we're owned and operated by the Saginaw YMCA, but we're open to anybody. In July we have summer camp, so ages 7 through about 16 we've got programs for. But then throughout the year, we have weekend camps, we have adult-only weekends, we have family camps, Labor Day and Memorial Day are two popular ones, 4th of July family camps usually. So year-round, we have events coming out here. We have a lot of local activity where we have cross-country skiing in the winter that comes out, so it's a year-round getaway for folks.
Okay, now, do they normally come in groups, or do people come in as individuals?
What's the best way? Yeah, that's a great question. Usually groups come out. So usually it's groups signed up ahead of time. We always have our events on our website. It's www.camptimbers.org, and that'll show events coming up. And usually it's something pre-scheduled. Occasionally we do have people come by. We've got things like zip lines and horses, and occasionally people can come and just add in last minute. But usually it's a scheduled event.
Okay. Well, tell us a little bit more about the camping and what facilities you have and so forth.
Sure. So we have 16 cabins on site. We also do all of the programming, all the meals, all the cleaning. So it's really a place where your family gets to come and enjoy camp and enjoy each other and not worry about all the extra things. That's the big benefit of us. Program-wise, we've got a 30-acre lake right behind us here, Piper Lake. We have a high ropes course, two zip lines. We have horses in the summer. And we have paddle boarding and canoeing and all sorts of fun things out on the lake, too. So a lot of activities for people to choose from.
Okay, you can also bike around here, too.
You can. 300 acres, so plenty of trails to bike on and hike on. Yep. Mm-hmm.
Okay. And so people that come in, now are they renting the cabins? Is that how it works?
Yeah, yep. Usually it's set up so you as a rental, whether it's a family group or if it's an individual basis. Yep.
Okay. And that allows them to use most of the other stuff?
Yeah, so it's a package deal. So if you come out to one of our events, we do, like I said, all the meals, all the cleaning. They stay in our cabins, and we do the programming, too.
Oh, what about camping? If somebody wants to bring their own tents?
We don't really do private camping with tents. It's usually just through our cabins.
Just through the cabins. Well, that's good. I see you've got some other buildings here, too. What all have you got?
Yeah, so we have our lodge where we do all of our meals. We've got, like, offices. We also have a climbing tower out back that we may show some footage of later. We got a waterfront. So most of the things we do at Camp Timbers are outdoors.
Do campfires, too?
We do huge campfires. Yeah, we love our campfires.
Absolutely. Oh, I bet that would be fun. Yeah. Get everybody together at night.
Oh, yeah, and all the great camp skits and songs and all the camp energy, too. That's one of the things we specialize in.
Sounds like a lot of fun. I'd like to take a look around.
Absolutely, yeah. Let's take a walk.
One of the best ways to explore the white pine forest of the 300-acre Camp Timbers and the 15-acre Piper Lake area is riding horseback through its trails.
So this is our horse pasture. One of the things that we do offer at Camp Timbers is a horse specialty camp. So for campers, they can come out for a week and spend 2 hours a day just getting to know the horses, learn about how to take care of them, riding on all of our trails that we have on our 300 acres. Some of the nice, unique things that we offer at Camp Timbers is the horse experience, too.
Paid horseback riding is available on a first-come, first-served basis. When young YMCA campers choose the boots and saddle horse specialty activity, they get to spend 2 hours each day focusing on horse care, riding instructions, and horseback rides along the trails and surrounding camp. Isn't it everyone's dream to fly through the air, getting from here to there in the briefest of time? Camp Timber's answer is its ever-popular zip line. With a few clicks of the harness and a couple of deep breaths, a zipline rider can soar through the treetops while hooked to an incline cable. Camp Timbers expert guides teach you the safety and protocol of ziplining while offering you an unforgettable experience. The first thing was to climb to the platform at the start of the zipline at the athletic field.
Check 3 is a check. Check 4 is great getaways. Check 5.
When I arrived at the platform, all I had to do was step off, ignoring the fact that it was higher than the trees.
All right, well, here I go again. This is the big zip line. This is about 1,200 feet. I'm gonna go down over a grassy area across the swamp, and they're gonna catch me at the other end. Brian's down there waiting for me, so take that leap of faith again. All right.
Your place is always so
the hard part. All right, everybody ready?
Are you ready?
Yeah, well.
Can I fix this for you real quick? There you go.
Okay. Yeah, I'm ready.
I then began soaring down a 1,200 foot line across the backwaters of Piper Lake, where at the end I was safely gathered and set free. I was propelled on this adventure ride by the force of gravity, accelerating as I reached the maximum velocity. Of course, the less friction your body provides, the faster you go. The zip line is open to all ages, and like any summer camp outdoor activity, teaches resilience while having the time of your life. Camp Timbers also makes use of the Ogemaw Hills and gives a whole new definition to the word tubing and sledding. The summertime activity is not for the faint of heart as you launch yourself on a small plastic sled into the black abyss of a corrugated tube for a quick ride that can be described as a summer luge. The Ogemaw Hills Path is a four-season playground, and we start off on our two-wheeled transportation for some exhilarating fun.
Well, we were just out here on the trail. We seen you guys coming in on bikes. You get out here very often?
Quite often, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, it's a great trail. It's all mapped. Can't get lost. So
Okay. She
almost hit a deer today.
Really?
Down the hill.
Yep. No kidding.
So it's probably on our camera. And we've seen owls out here. It's good fun. Uphill, downhill, and a lot of nice single tracks. So, yeah.
Now, you do this trail a lot then?
About every third Tuesday, a group of us do.
Okay, so you're from the area?
Right, yeah.
Okay.
Yep. So, yeah, it's a good ride out here, and I ride from our house to here. It's about 4 miles, so.
Okay, but, so you kind of get ready to hit the trail when you get here, huh?
Yep, get a little warm up, so it's good. But.
So tell me a little bit about the trails themselves. Are they pretty good for the bikes?
Oh, yeah. Yep, there's a cedar swamp you go through. There's several uphill, downhill swings where you'll get momentum and go right up the other side, and... there's a back swell way back there where you can feel the temperature drop 15 degrees when you go down into the hollow of it.
No kidding.
So, yeah. You always feel like there's a bear watching you or something when you're down back in there.
Get into the swampy here.
Right.
You kind of feel that way sometimes.
Yeah.
Well, now, what about you? How is this for you? You know, he's at this all the time, I know. Do you get out here quite a bit, too?
Not usually, except for skiing in the winter, so...
Okay, so you're pretty active though, so coming out here on a bike probably isn't that hard for you.
Mm.
Okay, what do you think about other people your age that maybe don't do it as much? Could they get out here and do that too?
Probably.
Okay, it's a nice enough trail then that they can go through pretty good.
It's just bumpy.
Just bumpy, yeah. I have ridden enough trails myself. I know how that feels sometimes.
Yep.
The Ogemaw Hills Pathway is located at the corner of Clear Lake Road and Fairview Road, just a few miles from the I-75 business spur. Bring your all-terrain or fat-wheel bike to enjoy a ride through the Osaba River Forest. The clearing as you enter the pathway is an old farm field slowly being reclaimed by the forest. Old fence lines, orchards, rock piles, lilacs, and foundations long since abandoned can be found as you explore and ride through the area. The terrain, as described by a biker, has a little longer climbs and downhills compared to what you usually find in Michigan, so you can get some great speed in places with good climbs. Spring, summer, and fall are all unique times of the year to hike the same paths as you bike. The Ogemaw Hills Pathway also provides a quiet, peaceful setting for a scenic walk through nature on beautiful wooded pathways. Did someone say hiking? You don't have to tell me twice. I was ready and willing to get outdoors and enjoy this beautiful color on foot. Much of the state forest land originated after large forest fires during the early 1900s, and many areas were replanted by the Civilian Conservation Corps. We wouldn't be hiking alone and would be joined by Jack Peterson, a local hiker. Jack would be our guide and give us some insight into the trails and their surroundings.
One of the things that I always like to do is go out hiking, no matter what time of the year it is, but especially here in the fall. We're up to the Ogemaw Hills Pathway, and this is just a beautiful area up here. There's a lot of hills and a lot of pathway. I'm with Jack Peterson right now, and Jack knows this area pretty good. He's from the area, retired school teacher, and he comes out here hiking, biking, and skiing quite often. Is that right, Jack?
That's right.
Okay, tell us a little bit about the trail. What are we going to get into here?
Well, it's very hilly. It's a mixed hardwood forest. There are about 30 miles of trails out here, so we can might encounter anything. I'm sure we'll run across some animals, hear some, and maybe see some.
In terms of forest cover types, this area varies from large expanses of jack pine on the sandy plains to low conifer swamps. The tree species are primarily associated with jack pine, red pine, and black oak in the sandy areas. Finally, on the ridges along the higher elevations, big tooth aspen and red oak are found on the better quality soils. Much of the state forest land originated after large forest fires during the early 1900s, and many areas were replanted by the Civilian Conservation Corps.
We've noticed as we've been walking along the trail that every so often we're finding benches. So if you are out here, you want to stop and take a rest, there is a place to sit down, maybe have a bite to eat, just relax and enjoy the solitude that's out here. They look like they're sitting awful high though, Jay.
Well, for right now they are. You can jump up there if you're hiking, but when you're skiing in the winter, they'll be at normal level because you'll be on a couple feet of snow here.
Okay.
Snowpack.
That makes sense. When I first looked at that, I thought, this sure is odd, but then that makes sense. That would, I would do it.
No. Great day.
No, it really is, you know. It's supposed to get warmer through the rest of the week, and this is just, like I said, it's hard to believe it's October, but this is what many times we call the Indian summer. It's that late period that it warms up and it's really nice and the colors come out. Yes. And it's that way quite a bit up here. So, well, I guess I can't really guarantee that, but it's that way when we come here. So, it's just a beautiful day. Just beautiful.
Thanks, Jack. It's always nice to hike with someone so knowledgeable about their environment. Along the ridges of the higher elevations of the pathway are big tooth aspen and red oak. Much of the state's forest land was replanted after the large forest fires of the early 1900s. So do something good for yourself and enjoy the outdoors. Take a hike to reduce stress, increase your vigor, and improve your sleep. Stop and smell the trees for a healthier overall mental state. Combining the benefits of exercise with the benefits of a forest setting is a great recreation for the health conscious. If riding the trails is more to your liking, take the trails and routes of Ogemaw County. The trails for your single rider ATVs include the Ambrose Lake Trail, the 16-mile Ogemaw Hills Trail, and the Ogemaw Hill Trail to St. Helen. Take your ORVs on the Ogemaw Hill route. Ogemaw County has an ordinance that makes it easier for riders to get back and forth from the trails. It allows ORV riders to ride on the streets and highways in Ogemaw County. With ORVs growing in popularity, the maintenance of the Ogemaw trails and connections to the Michigan other trails makes this your ideal area for you and your friends to start your rides. Arnold Palmer said golf was deceptively easy and endlessly complicated. There's nothing complicated about getting a tee time in Ogemaw County. West Branch has a collection of great 18-hole golf courses just minutes from your hotel room. They offer challenging, exciting, and affordable golf for every level of golfer. From rolling hills, wooded fairways, bunkers, and water, the picturesque vistas provided at each golf course make them a pleasure to play. Each course has velvety smooth and exceptionally fast greens. Their gorgeous landscape has been thoughtfully designed and share the natural beauty of the rolling northern Michigan terrain. From golfing in the early morning and enjoying the beautiful sunrises, to spending the day in the open air freshness, to the twilight game and gorgeous sunsets, your outdoor vacation will be complete on the links of Ogemaw County. Tweet us with your score at greatgetaways.tv.
We're at the Ogemaw County Nature Park right now. I am with Aaron, and he is the groundskeeper out here. And Aaron, tell us a little bit about the park. What is it exactly?
It's actually just a great place that has been started many years ago with a guy who lived up at the house, actually. And it was around the 20s. He would feed the deer because he was a big animal lover. and he would feed the deer, and they would come, and he actually put a bell up for them, and he would ring the bell, and they would all just come in.
No kidding.
Yep, and then after a while, the people around the canoe community, they were all about that. They wanted to bring their kids over, because the deer, you could go right up to them and pet them. Okay. So they were doing that, and then after a while, you know, they thought it was a very big thing for the community. So the DNR took it over in around the 40s.
Okay.
The DNR took it over for a place for people to come. So that's, and then they fenced in a few of the deer because the more people they came, the harder it was to get the deer in.
Okay.
And then as from then on, everyone saw that it's been such a great thing, but the funding has been hard to get because it's just, we go off of donation and fundraisers. So then the Tens Lake Sports Club took over from them, and then when they were no longer able to keep it up, Ogemaw County took it over, and they are taking it over right now, and we're having some trouble with keeping it open, but we are doing our best, making improvements. I mean, as you can see, plenty of people love to come out and experience it. Children, they love to come out, play with all the other kids in the park. The deer will come up to them pretty much, almost like pets, kind of.
When visiting the Ogemaw Nature Park, it is one way to give children and adults the opportunity to have an up-close experience with Michigan's white-tailed deer. The park's caretakers want visitors to learn what a precious resource the deer are here in Michigan. By visiting the park, you will become aware of the ways you can play a more active role in ensuring the continued success of the deer. That is the goal of the park, both for the hunters and others, to help the survival of the species.
We have a piebald, which is extremely friendly for all the kids. And we have a various assortment of nice looking bucks if you just want to come and see some bucks and feed them. And
some of those got some nice racks going on.
Oh, yes, they do. Yep. Oh, yeah, we try to keep them as happy and healthy as possible, and it just keeps people coming.
I noticed, too, that you've got a lot of toys out here that the kids can mm-hmm. play. It's just like a big park out here.
Yes, we try to keep it a very family-oriented place. We love to have big groups of families just come out, spend some time with your kids, play in our sandbox, go down our slide, swing set, feed our deer. We'd love to have everybody.
Okay, gives the kids all a chance, too, to come out and see an actual deer. Yep. Out in the mm-hmm. middle of nowhere here. Picnics too, I see you got
Yes, you can have picnics out here. We're going to soon. We're gonna try to add some grills out here. We can have some barbecues with the family. Wow. We got a little concession stand if you want some drinks or anything. And we're gonna actually add some like horseshoe pits and stuff for some of the grown-ups to have some stuff to
cool.
do.
Very good. Nice place to come out here. Maybe you can tell us where we're at.
We are, we're at the Ogemaw Nature Park. We are on
Rose
City Road, and it is pretty much in between Rose City and St. Helen, or Clear Lake and St. Helen.
So it's not really hard to find. Though.
Nope.
And you can come along the road, and once you're on the road, you're going to see it. It's
and
easy
all
to
of
find.
Our, so. All of our information for our phone numbers, our place to get here is all on Facebook or our website.
What's your website?
I believe it is Ogemaw Nature Park, but our best way to get through is our Facebook account.
Okay, and we'll also hook it up to our website at greatgetaways.tv. All this kind of stuff that we do, we like to put that on there so everybody can find it easy too. Eric, thank you very much. We appreciate it. We're going to take a look around and enjoy ourselves.
Thank you very much.
All right.
The park is a non-profit facility with free admission. If you want to make a vacation memories that will last a lifetime, come to the park with your children and grandchildren and listen to their squeals of delight as they hand-feed the small herd of white-tailed deer. Bags of feed are available to purchase for a small fee, and the fee goes to keeping the park in operation. The Ogemaw Nature Park is in a secluded environment that is extremely peaceful and relaxing. Families can bring their lunch and spend the day in a safe environment as the facility is completely fenced in so the kids can run free. Perhaps your dream outdoor recreation involves being on the water. If that is so, a portion of the Osable State Forest has been set aside for the Rifle River Recreation Area. Rifle River Recreation Area is a 4,329-acre wilderness located within the Osable State Forest in Ogemaw County and provides a variety of recreational opportunities.
We're here at the Rifle River Recreation Area. We're at Grebe Lake. Now, for those that have been out here, the way you might understand where this lake is at is there's a, an overlooked tower that's just down from here. And a lot of people that come out here will stop at this tower and go up and you can overlook this lake. I'm with Dominic right now. Dominic, why don't you tell us a little bit about the lake and this fabulous ramp that you've got here.
Yeah, the lake has been a great fishing lake. Lots of bass, lots of pike come out of this lake. The handicap accessible pier that we have is a few years old, about 7 or 8 years old. And it's great for kayakers, experienced kayakers, or even new kayakers. You know, it's got the great rolling bars for easy entry and easy exit when you're coming out of the lake. In the fishing pier at the end, they do fishing programs once a week here with the Explorer Guide. So kids from all ages can come out and fish on the program. If they're 16 or under, they don't need a license. If they're above 16, they would need the fishing license.
Okay, real quick, too, how many other lakes are out here?
7 lakes altogether at the rec area here.
So. Are they all open then to kayaking and boating and things like that?
We've got 2 lakes that are a little bit you'd have to hike back into.
Okay.
You're able to go back and use that if you can get your boat back there or your kayak back there. But pretty much 5 of them are open and readily accessible with boat launches and that type of thing.
All open to fishing?
So, yep.
Okay. Are there some of them got special regulations though?
Not anymore.
Oh no.
They Jewett Lake used to be catch and release only,
right.
And they couldn't use live bait. But now that has been lifted. The Grouse Haven and DeVoe Lake are feed the Rifle River.
Okay.
So those would be trout lakes.
Okay. So. And then you also have just a variety of type of camping going on out here.
Correct. 174 campsites.
Now, do you have electricity and that hookups like
we
that?
We do. Yep. Our modern campground has electricity. Those are the Front and Grouse Haven campground. And then we have approximately 100 sites that are rustic. And those are just the lot and the pit toilets.
Okay. So. Open pretty much all year long?
They are. Our modern is open year-round with a modern bathroom building, and that stays open year-round.
Wow.
Our rustic, we close down early December.
Okay. But so. They still can use the park?
People they can use the park. Yep. We have 5 cabins throughout the park that people, four-wheelers, they can go back and four-wheel drive vehicles.
Right.
Because we don't plow those roads. They can go back and camp there. We have a lot of cross-country skiing trails that people use in the winter and just enjoy the park. Ice fishing is a big hit here, so people come out on the lakes and ice fish.
Okay, and just keep remembering that we're just north of West Branch and just east of Rose City. It's not a long jump for most of the people here in Michigan, and it's a great park to come out to.
There's a public canoe access at the Rifle River and the Rifle River Recreation Area. You can enjoy the serenity of the Rifle River by canoeing, kayaking, and even tubing. It's a great way to enjoy nature. The water is beautiful, clear blue-green color. When off the water at night, you may hear hooting owls, howling coyotes, and observe brilliant shooting stars in the dark skies. Also, observed along the water trail are beaver dams, water birds, and eagles. The Rifle provides fair to good brown trout fishing during the spring until about the last week of June, and again from Labor Day until the end of trout season. At these times, spin casting with hardware and streamer fly fishing are productive methods.
Beautiful fish. That pretty much about a standard size in here then?
Yeah, it's pretty good size, yep. You want to catch them about that size, I'm a good eaters right there.
Okay. That's something out here camping, and it'd be good.
It's a big good. Yep, you betcha.
Although brown trout typically predominate the tributaries of the Rifle, some fine brook trout fishing are also present.
You don't have to come up here and have any experience at all, really.
No.
I mean, people think fly fishing, oh, God, I can't do that. I can't even fish. But you don't need that. You don't need that.
No.
That's what you're here for.
Yep, all you got to do is have the willing to be able to try. Because most of us can get you to fish, put you on fish. A lot of it is presentation when it comes down to dry fly fishing, but when you're nymph fishing or streamer fishing, it's luck of the draw sometimes. Just where the fish are be and whether you keep one on and the fight of the fish. But I tell people, and most of the clientele know, it's not always about catching fish. It's more about spending the day having a great conversation in an area that most people don't even get to see.
It would be hard for me to choose just one of the many activities we got to experience today for an out-of-doors vacation in Ogemaw County. I sure enjoyed them all, and we know you will too. Be sure to sign in on the online adventure and request a free DVD of today's show to review all there is to do. We will see you on Facebook and hope you stay in touch following our tweets. And be sure to check our Pinterest boards for interesting photos to pin from our great getaways. Take note of the contact information on the screen and learn more about West Branch and Ogemaw County for your next great getaway. Thanks for spending time with us. Now get outdoors and enjoy yourself.